Today we're talking about what I had to change on the tune to get the big block started. Stick around. What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the garage, and I hope you don't mind that I sit down. My back is killing me. But while I'm sitting here, I noticed, check out that ICT billet banner in the background. Go give those guys a holler. Check out their website. I'm running their parts on this vehicle. I'm running them on the Cadillac. I'm running them on the Superauto. I have ICT billet in every single vehicle that I own. Well, except for the YS Jeep. There's no modifications on that. But I guarantee you, if I were to do some mods on it, there would be ICT billet parts on there. So I want to thank those guys as always, along with Nitrous Express, man. We got great sponsors here, so I always like to give them a quick shout out. But today, you guys want to know what it took to get the Terminator X running the Big Block 598. If you didn't see that video, I'll post a link up in the corner. Go watch the first start. Sorry, part of it got cut off. And in fact, the part that got cut off was whenever I finally got the thing fired up and had a huge intake leak that shot the RPMs up to like 3,000 RPMs, freaked me out. But there was some changes that I had to make. So I've got the tune pulled up right here. And in fact, this is the tune that I just did for the sensor update, which is another video that I'm going to be putting out that shows you how to set up custom sensors for like fuel and oil pressure. But let's take a look at the big thing. The first thing that we had to do was under ignition parameters. Remember, we're running the Holley dual sync, but we've got the blank cap on there. We don't have the cap and rotor on there. And because of that, we actually have to set it up as custom. There is a Holley dual sync option in the dropdown, but that is assuming that you're running a points output over to like an MSD 6 box, something like that. So it's using the point output. We have to go into custom because we're using coil on plug, and we need to be able to come in here and select DIS coil on plug. That way we get the 8 individual trigger outputs to the different coils. On top of it, we need to set up a couple different things. We're going to be 1 pulse per fire with the digital falling on the crank sensor. We're also going to be a single pulse digital falling on the cam sensor. Now, for the crank sensor, the inductive delay, they suggest that you start around 100 U-seconds, which is what, nanoseconds, milliseconds should be M-seconds, must be a nanosecond. Comment down below if you know what USEC stands for in this case. And then the ignition reference angle is that clocking of the distributor that you do whenever you initially set it up. Now, I talked about this in the last video, but I think it got cut off. I had to re-clock my distributor a couple times to get what is effectively was number one in the right position versus the pickup. There's a little black pickup in the bottom of the case of the dual sync. That is the start of the crank sensor. The cam sensor is right beside it. You can't really see that one because it's on an internal wheel. But what needs to happen is the wheel where the rotor would be, there is a notch that indicates where that point would be, and that has to be where you line that up on that black sensor in order to get your timing right. I ended up having to pull the spark plugs out in order to get enough RPMs and put a timing light on there to realize that it was basically the firing order was stepped back one. And I could have gone into the tune and just changed the order through there, but it's, you know, at that point in time, let's go ahead and do it right. Let's get number one cylinder where the Terminator X thinks number one cylinder is. After I did that, I went ahead and used the timing light and hooked onto the Terminator. And you can come down here whenever you're online, and there's the option right here to set static timing. I set that to 15 degrees and then adjusted or shot the timing light on there, and we were reading about 16 degrees or so. And then I adjust this ignition reference angle until 15 degrees was showing up on the balancer because that's what we were commanding in here. So normally that starts around 50, but as I said, by using the timing light, we adjust it here to get that to be online. And that way, our timing adjustments throughout the range are good to go. And the reason that we use 50 is so that we are giving the ECU enough heads up in order to make the timing adjustments. We're saying 50 degrees beforehand. The ECU knows, hey, well, in this case, 48.5 degrees beforehand. The ECU knows, hey, I've got 48.5 degrees. If I'm doing 15 degrees of advance, I need to subtract that from the 48.5, and that's whenever I fire, etc. So the other big thing was we were really short on fuel, which I was surprised because if you go in and look at the ECU configuration under engine parameters, we have an engine displacement that we're putting in there, 598 cubic inches. It almost seems to me that this doesn't make a darn bit of difference. And I'll tell you why. Because I had to come in under fuel and really jack this base fuel table up. And in fact, you can look, we're down here kind of in this range. We're in the 154s. Let's go ahead and open up the original one and look. And we were at the 40s. We added over 100% volumetric efficiency on the fuel side. And if we look at the conversion, you know, it doesn't look quite as crazy on this side of things. But that was one big thing that I had to do, was add in a lot of fuel, over 100% across. And the fuel side, it's higher, but it's not as high in relative, in relation to what we did on the volumetric efficiency table. So I need to do a little research as to why this is. This wigs me out a little bit, thinking that we have more than 100% volumetric efficiency on our motor when we actually don't, because you know, we're saying up in this range we're flowing 200%. That would mean that we're moving, I don't know, what's 9.9 liters of air times two? So, you know, 19 liters of air per stroke or per revolution, basically. That's not true. But getting this much fuel in there got us to the point where we were running. On top of it, I had to add a lot of startup enrichment, and this is straight just pounds per hour. Not that surprised that I had to add startup enrichment. You've got to remember that this tune file was set up for a 454. We're at a 598. And so you could probably go in and look at the original 454 file, do some calculation in percentage from a 454 to a 598 or a 632, whatever you're using it for, and then you could apply that percentage to this table to bring it up. I just brought it up 15%, 10%, things like that, until it got to the point where it was lighting off consistently. So those were the two big things that kept it from running. Now that it's up and running, it fires up pretty quick. The other issue that I was having was the cam crank sensor. There's an LED on the back of the Terminator X. LEDs 6 and 7, I believe, is which ones they are, indicate the status of the cam and the crank sensor, and both of those were going red. The cam sensor more than the crank were going red. But I was still getting spark, and that's what was weirding me out. And I ended up chasing my tail on that a little bit longer than I needed to. What happens is you're still getting spark. Whenever the thing does light off, then those go away. In fact, those LEDs just turn off whenever the thing's running. And I, you know, if you go in and look at the documentation, it talks about, oh, if it means this, it means you have a bad crank signal or you have a bad cam signal. That does not actually seem to be the case on the Terminator. Those LEDs can be a little bit misleading. So do your checks if you're getting those red lights on cam and crank. Verify you've got fuel. Verify you got spark, because spark is going to be the big one. I listened to the injectors whenever cranking. I could hear the injectors, you know, stick the screwdriver on there on the end of the injector. You'll hear them clicking every so often. And then I could see spark. So I had fuel and spark. The third part, air. Of course, we got that. So those lights are lying. I wouldn't put much weight into the cam and crank sensor lights. So that pretty much wraps up this video that talks about what it took to get the Terminator X up and running, first start. We did a video earlier on, I can throw a link up in the corner for that, where I set the tune up initially. This is what I had to do to that initial setup tune in order to actually get it running. So pretty straightforward, nothing big there. I'm going to get back to it. You guys know the drill. Thanks for stopping by the garage, and remember, ABT, always be tuning.